Oh, I hurt my neck.
I'll have a blue Christmas without you.
When you're lonely, life is getting you lonely. You can always go down.
You know Jim Reavers, man. You and Jim go way back, don't you?
Yeah, man.
But I have a blue, 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 blue Christmas.
A week of fun-filled activity, I told him. We'd do a little paddling. A little hiking. And some fishing. So we set out for the boundary waters of northern Minnesota. You be the woodsman, Galen the cook, me the guide, and the boss. Muby was worried about bears, so he'd run around the campsite practicing to be sure he could outrun somebody if one came to camp. We paddled, fished, ate, and slept, and listened to the call of the wild. Where is that when nature calls? Well, we made do. And you know, it just doesn't get any better than this.
Bet you wish you were here, Bill Wagner.
In an effort to find the perfect production vehicle, Metro Video Productions has granted its employees the money to design and develop vehicles that will cut down on drive time between offices. Mark Agee equipped his vehicle with a German sport suspension, but it proved to be a little too road-weary for the 10-CD changer installed in the trunk. John Wilcox developed this personal rocket traveler to expedite his commute from Virginia Beach to Williamsburg. Although he finally perfected his invention, he is currently working at home, waiting for Tidewater to freeze. This simple, efficient design by Scott Newborn was never up to par. "He keeps breaking it, and I keep fixing it," said mechanic Bill Brown. When asked if the purpose of the elevated paddles was to allow the vehicle to skim above the road, John Stout replied, "No, that's to power the six-line cellular phone." Scott Johnston, in an effort to come up with extra pocket change for his Christmas gifts, saved money by not installing an engine. Elaborate fashion is the moniker for this design. Bill Wagner, seen here, said, "Although my vehicle does not move, I feel so much cooler."
In Williamsburg, there's one place where man and nature come together to produce a vintage place to live. Where river breezes lift to tease age-old limbs reaching to the sky. Where life's greatest rewards are found in the smallest of moments. It is a place near the heart of a city with a treasured past.
Where past and present coincide. Where classic ways are not forgotten.
All the best of life's pleasures. There is one place. There is one place.
The right time. The right place.
The place?
The Vineyards at Jockey's Neck. Windsor House on the James.
Monterey Shores.
The Villages of Kiln Creek.
This is Buck Island.
Ford's Colony. For a complete list of places, call 1-800-1-PLACE. No fee required for printed material, but shipping and handling is $19.95. Visa and MasterCard accepted.
I'm looking for a production company, one that's not too big, but yet not too small. A company with updated equipment, but won't overwhelm me with all the latest toys. A group that is willing to work a lot of hours. I mean, a lot of hours, and not complain. They can't be too expensive, but yet again, not too cheap. A company that is sound financially, maybe with some resort real estate holdings. A company that's got it all. Ah, that's what I'm looking for.
And I'm being laid off. Tax, pension, and investment questions are forced on us now.
In a press conference today, Mark Agee of LIDS International displayed the newest technology in advanced hair follic replacement. Aptly titled Transformer Hair, this new product can be twisted, molded, and folded into inanimate objects, seen here as a hat. Mr. Agee said that although this technology is new to the world, we've been working on it for 5 years, and that his partner, Mr. Mewborn, is currently working on hair products that move about the head on their own power.
And that's enough for nothing. Thank you.
Phil Brown sings the music of Jim Nabors.
Do it.
Lick it. Lick it.
Just wanted to get that on tape.
This is Cole's first video. His first cooking show. His first co-appearance with Mommy.
John, I got a close-up.
Wow. Oh, man, this is going to toast me. I'm going to lose about 10 pounds. Did you do this, hey?
No.
You dirty man.
It's perfectly healthy. You're on any medication, are you?
That's a Christmas video.
You're not on the filter, right?
Smoke coming out.
Okay,
of my mouth.
I need you on the other side of the filter.
We're here at the Il Yunque National Forest, and it's an unusual phenomenon here at the top. When it's the perfect day and the clouds are right, there's a full moon over the Il Yunque National Forest.
Oh.
At first glance, you see a pretty full lid, and you're wondering, who's this? Tilt down a little farther, yeah, I got a few wrinkles up there, so it's probably not Mewborn. Well, it can be Mewborn, look at that. Or AG. Or maybe AG got a new lid. No, probably not. Oh, right there, it gives it away. Zoom out. Who, who is it? Whose profile could that possibly be? Let's see, it's not Billy Ray.
Down here and give us a hand.
Here we are on the Outer Banks, just putting some.
Yeah, it's done.
FO tape.
Let's move in.
Stop rolling.
Well done.
Our house is a very, very, very fine house.
I was working the evening shift, shooting the big town for a real estate marketing video. Why? Because that's what I do. I'm Billy Ray, the real estate interpreter. I was hired to capture the mood of the city and the river that runs through it. After poking my lens all day at the deference to dead men who lived in an era of misguided social intent, and the steel-mirrored phallic monuments of today's falsely empowered heroes, I moved across the river to perch for sunset. The river. It slices this town like a dull-edged razor blade through the thin-skinned wrists of the suicidally undecided. It divides, but leaves plenty of time to think it over and call 911. From my outpost, I was catching the sun's final wink at our part of the world, when suddenly I heard a faint call. It reminded me of the whimpering of fallen white-tailed does. I pushed my way to the sound, and there she was, eyes round and full, with a twinkle that only the most aged Himalayan monks could resist. But I had work to do, and returned to my vigilant posture. As the sun was dissipating, my thoughts formed around the day's events. When her shrill sound burst the night's air like a switchblade through a paper pinata on Cinco de Mayo. There she stood, eyes aflame. She tried to capture me with her mystique, but I had a job to fulfill. As the sun kissed this good earth goodnight, I folded my tripod and never heard or saw her again. But I replayed the vestiges of her vision over and over again in the estuary of my mind. Call me a sentimental relic of a bygone era, but I will always find a place in my heart for the woman who led me into the vestibule of life on the south side of the river, in the big town.
Williamsburg, Virginia, capital of colonial America, home of the Fife and Drum Corps. Williamsburg has it all. Theme parks, great recreation activities, a brewery, and when you're hungry, you go to Burger King. But don't bring your American Express card. They take Visa. Visa, it's everywhere you want to be.
Let me know if you need anything, fellas. Don't get up, I'll get it.
Glad that I got a chance to do it.
Where would I be without you, Phil?
Newborn's the name and my hair's got a fade. Call me Mewby, but don't call me Wade. Everything I say and everything I does usually ends up with sorry fellas. Whenever I drive, I scare the gang. They always say, eyes forward, bang! Lids International, I'm president of. I got to the top due to lack thereof. All the long trips I like to go, cause the food on the road is free, don't you know? My boss gives me jobs and I never frown. I just say, yes sir, Stooley Brown.
My day today was real slow. Real slow.
Joseph Scott Wheeler returned to the United States today. Mr. Wheeler, seen here with his first and third wife, Beth Rutgers, was happy just to be home. The 85-year-old philanthropist returned from his successful international video tour. The video, entitled Trading Your Way to Personal Wealth, has reached sales of over 30 billion worldwide and is required reading in U.S. grammar schools. When asked if his system works, Ms. Rutgers chimed in, "How do you think I got this Rolex?" The Wheelers were pleased to set foot on solid ground again and were thrilled when their eldest son, Coleman, president of Metro Video Real Estate Productions, greeted them ashore. JSW is looking forward to getting back in the saddle. Coleman said, one deal in the works involves beachfront property in Somalia.
We're all going to lunch, so if the phone rings, would you mind just picking up and take a message, and we'll get back to them when we get back from lunch. We'll see you then. Bye-bye.
Okay, sure. Don't forget to come back.
Okay.
Hello, this is Metro Video Productions.
This is Bob Sanders, Eschbach at Virginia Power Ethel Center for Devil and Chesapeake Corporation. I need a new video by 1 o'clock, or you'll never get any business from us again.
Yes, sir.
I'm Suzanne Martin, and this is Metro's Most Wanted. It's come to our attention that due to the recession, some Metro employees have turned to a part-time life of crime. By day, they're overworked, underpaid, average, not in a rock band type of guys. But by night, they're desperate criminals, striving to destroy the very fabric of our society. Please, be on the lookout for Mark Leadfoot Agee, speed demon getaway driver for the notorious Metro Gang of Thugs. He's best known for his ability to test the limits of any vehicle and can be recognized by the word Farfignugan tattooed on his forehead. Scott Babyface Mewborn, given that nickname because his high forehead resembles that of a three-month-old infant. He is the lookout man during operations and can be recognized by the dazed, confused look and the gigantic scar on his belly. Patrick, I'm only uptight because my socks don't fit, Dunn, the inside man, given that job because of his uncanny ability to keep his cool under stress. You'll recognize him by watching out for thin ties and a thick accent. And the ringleader of this gang of ragtag fugitives, John Achu Powers, most recently seen infiltrating the handkerchief section of a local department store. This man has never passed a polygraph test and is constantly being hounded by authorities. If you've seen any of these men, do not, I repeat, do not try to apprehend, as they are extremely ticklish. This is Suzanne Tatohead Martin saying, do it to them before they do it to you.
And now, Metro News Update with David Gow.
Hello, I'm Dave Gowan. I need a raise. In the news today, a new memo has been issued in response to Scott Wheeler's recent embarrassing injury. The memo states that from now on, whenever any employee is performing a job that involves sitting, they are now required to use the new Dillon sitting ring. All sizes have been ordered from petite to Bertha. This year's ITVA Christmas party saw the introduction of the new Metro mascot on wheels. We'd like to welcome him to our family, and we hope to spend many hours and production meetings with him in the near future.
Right.
In other news tonight, our undercover photographer did some after-hours sneaking to discover that Metro actually is a rock band. Further investigations uncovered that when their lyrics are played backwards, they slightly resemble the satanic phrase, time bank, my sweet time bank. Nipper, the famous RCA mascot, seen frequently hanging around the Metro Richmond office, died today after committing suicide off the roof of a downtown Richmond skyscraper. Apparently, his appointment as coordinator of the Metro Revision Division was too much for his puny brain to handle, and he finally went over the edge. There were no pedestrian injuries, and a neighboring Chinese restaurant was more than eager to help clean up the mess. In other news, Geraldo Rivera is making headlines again, this time by breaking into Al Capone's mother's basement vault. The whole world was shocked to discover on live national TV that he found Jeff Foster, Julie Day, Doug Sharp, Catherine Hudson, John Morris, Tim Farrow, and Jimmy Hoffa. In the wake of Superman's death, there have been recent sightings in downtown metropolitan Williamsburg of a short, brown-haired man. The man has been spotted with blue and red tights caught in his zipper in several antique phone booths. His identity remains a mystery.
Right.
First, there was seafood Outer Bank style. Then there was a taste of Williamsburg. Well, those crazy Metro cooks are at it again, this time right in the heart of downtown Richmond. A Taste of the Bottom, featuring such delicacies as White Cloud Soufflé, Richmond Rump Roast, and Cheese Wedgies, are just some of the items we can look forward to on this forthcoming video. Your hosts, Beth Rutgers and Dick Butkus, will walk you through these finger-licking good recipes in their inimitable tongue-in-cheek fashion. Remember, a mind is a terrible thing to waste. A recent public dispute between Metro's Mark Agee and Scott Mewborn regarding lids surprised local onlookers as tensions rose to a new high. Apparently, when Mewborn stated that at least he was beginning to look as dignified as Montel Williams, Agee responded with, "Don't compare yourself to Montel Williams. I know Montel Williams, and believe me, you're no Montel." In a related story, Montel Williams is listed in stable condition at Riverside Regional Medical Center and his nose in satisfactory condition at Stewart Circle Hospital in Richmond. That does it for this time around. For Metro News Update, I'm Average, and I'm History.
Coming soon to a theater near you.
A movie so scary, you'll wet your pants. It stalks you unsuspectingly, leaving a menacing trail of mutilation. A new villain who is utterly terrifying. Beware, Das Boom. Rated FNG, not suitable for younger audiences.